Layers of Orchestral Tools is a free orchestral plugin that really blew us away. This free orchestra is a must-have. In this video, we explain how to download and install it and show you how it works and sounds. So stay tuned. First, let me ask you to subscribe to this YouTube channel. If you subscribe, we will keep you updated on all the great free software and tools we review every week. Layers of Orchestral Tools is a free plugin that is really impressive. It has a lot of features, and in this short video, we only show you how to install and play the sounds, but there is much more. To download this plugin, you have to go to their website and click on the Get It Free button. This brings you to the register page where you have to register for an account or log in if you already have an account on this website. You will receive an activation link in your email, so you have to click on that link to validate your account. By clicking on the link, you will be redirected to the page where you can buy the Layers plugin for $0 or euros. After clicking on the Buy button, you will see the download page of Layers. You can select Mac or Windows download. The Windows download comes as an .exe file and is actually the sine player, which is used to play lots of sounds of this company, so not only the free layers. Installing is quite easy. After installation, you have to log in on the sine player with the information you used when you created your account. This will open the standalone version of the sine player. Now you have to click on My Licenses at the right of the menu to load the sounds. Next, you will see the Layers info. Just click on Details and select the sounds you want to download. You can select the basic kit, which will select the close and three microphone positions, or you can select all of them if you have enough space on your computer. If you scroll down, you see what instruments you are downloading, and at the bottom you see the button to download the selected. If you click on the download, you will see how many gigabytes this will take, which was a bit confusing because it looks like it needs over 929 gigabytes to load everything, which we do not have on our computer. And it doesn't show the destination folder. But we found that the download was much less. Loading the basic set of all four instruments is around 4 gigabytes, and loading all mic positions of the four instruments is around 9 gigabytes. Downloading and unpacking will take a few minutes, and then you can start the sine player in standalone without using a DAW, or you can start your DAW and load the sine player as a plugin. We loaded the sine player in Cubase Elements and dragged it to a track. At first you see the library where you have layers downloaded in. Here you can check where the sounds are located by clicking on Settings. To use the sounds, you have to click on Browse. Now you see the four instrument groups you can choose from. If you click on Orchestra, you see the full orchestra, and if you click on that, you see 8 different chord styles. The first three are long sounding chords, so as long as you hold the key on your keyboard, the sound will be heard. You can use major, minor and sus4 chords. The next three options are short staccato hits in major, minor and sus4, and the last two are low notes for the basses in sustain, which is the long notes, or staccato, which is the short notes. If you only want to use long notes on one track, you can drag the first three to the articulation list at the right. Now, if you play single notes on your keyboard, you will hear a full chord. So playing a C note will play a full C chord with the orchestra. If you play a C note on a higher region of your keyboard, you hear that it changes to a higher setting. All you have heard now is the major chords. Now what if you want the minor and the sus4 chords? When you look at the articulation list, you see there is a note value in front of the chord. C1 is a key of the lower part of your keyboard that is used as a switch. You can see these settings if you choose the performance in the menu. You see a keyboard at the bottom where the white keys are the ones that you can play the sounds on, and the brown keys at the left are the ones that switch the chords. So you can switch from major to minor and sus4 by pressing this key on your keyboard. Now, another interesting thing is the dynamics. We are used to having dynamics using the velocity of the keyboard. Some sounds also work like this on here. The staccato sounds are played softer and louder by striking your key on the keyboard softer or harder. In the sustained sounds, it works differently. The intensity and volume of these sounds is done by using the modulation wheel on your keyboard. In full orchestra, it not only changes the volume, but also adds extra instruments in it. I will switch to the poly settings to show you graphically what's going on. This is working on all the four sets that we have, so also on the woodwinds, brass and strings. This sign player also works on several MIDI channels, so when you want to add an extra track with only brass, you can drag them to the list at the right and then use them on a separate channel. The channel number is shown at the left of this list. Now we have loaded several microphone positions and these can be seen at the mixer in the menu. Here you can set these on and off and mix them with the other mics. Also here you can select to which output the microphone should be sent. You can choose up to 32 stereo outputs. You also have to set these in your DAW or else you won't hear them. On the website of Orchestral Tools there is also a great video that explains how to work with this fantastic tool. So if you're interested, you have to check that out too. The link can be found on our website. You really have to learn how to work with this plugin, but once you know it, it's a joy to use it. A must-have in your collection of plugins. More information and the download link can be found on our website. The link is below our video. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep you updated on all the reviews we do.